14 to 9.
Defense and run transition, big 15-point lead, and the first quarter going to the hometown guys.
Anthony Frederick's shot won't go, rebounded by Burke, and that'll do it for the end of the quarter. The Spirits pick up a point in the standings. We'll explain that to you. 38-23, Savannah leading Mississippi. This is the CBA on ESPN. Like that. Same thing. Welcome back to the Savannah Civic Center, everybody. The length of the hockey game has pushed us into the second quarter already. I'm Bob Lewandowski, sitting in for Bob Lee, who's getting set for Big Monday later on here on ESPN. We'll tell you about that later. Irv Brown is my partner, and Irv, we've seen the transition game. Two teams that love to run it up and down the floor.
Boy, have we ever. Of course, Henry Bibby played at UCLA for John Wooden, and you know that they're going to get it up and down the court. You're going to see some UCLA high post offense and the 2-1-2 press. Out of the side of the coin, interesting situation in Mississippi. I'm not so sure if it wasn't for Bill Musselman that Tom Schneeman wouldn't be the coach of the year. He's done a great job with these guys. He's got them playing good basketball, and he's been everywhere. I remember the guy when he was at Summit County up in the hills of Colorado, and then he was at Washington State with George Raveling, spent some time in Detroit with Smokey Gaines. I mean, he's been everywhere. He's done a very good job with this ball club.
Irvin, that Mississippi team has won four in a row to solidify their position in second place in the Eastern Division standings of the CBA. Savannah was battling them for second throughout most of the season. They've fallen on some hard times lately. They've lost five of their last six, but have made four player moves here just in the last 48 hours. And hopefully they're going to shake things up. Now they're battling for the fourth and final playoff spot in the East. We're back to action.
Excuse me. The one thing you got to love about the CBA, even though it was a rout the first quarter, now we start over.
Wipe the slate clean. Each quarter worth a point in the standings. If you're new to CBA basketball, the seven-point system. This is Walker Russell. He played at Western Michigan, feeding Eddie Lee Wilkins for the one-hander.
He's just on fire. One of the better offensive players around. His problem is playing weak side defense. Nice block by Eddie. Nothing wrong with that. Here comes Othell.
Othell Wilson leads a two-on-one. They drop it for Wilkins.
Can't run it any better than that. Steve Burt with a solid assist. Henry's done a good job with his basketball team, getting ready to play on national TV.
16 points already for Eddie Lee Wilkins. He averages 25. 42-23, the Savannah Spirits leading the Mississippi Jets. Glad to have you along with us for professional basketball here on ESPN.
There's so many stories here as we look at Henry Bibby. His assistant there is Lenny Passing. Tico Brown, who's sitting out right now, is a legend down here. He has his own radio show. He's sports director down here. They love him.
Anthony Frederick. Chased down by Othell Wilson. Here's Walker Russell.
Guard-oriented offense along with Eddie Lee Wilkins. There's one of the guards.
And Russell connects.
Now, he can play a little bit. Started out, he was going to go to Michigan State. Grades weren't good. Went to a junior college, Oakland Community College. Goes to Western Michigan. It's been a very nice career for Walker.
And Mississippi needs a timeout. They trail 44-23. Savannah on top. We'll be back with more in just a moment. This is the CBA on ESPN. A good look at Henry Bibby, head coach of the Savannah Spirits. I'm Bob Lewandowski with Irv Brown. 44-23. Savannah leading Mississippi. Anthony Frederick ran down big number 52, Brian Riley, offensive foul.
Excuse me, Bob. Tommy Wood with the call. The other official is Daryl Humphrey. Well, look in the middle for the viewer. Watch number 52 for Mississippi. This is the guy I want to see. Not so much what happens today because he isn't ready. I want to see him in a year. 7'2", Lester Fonville. Now, the NBA is a big man's league, and yet there is an opportunity up there. I watched as Kevin Duckworth now with Portland, and it just tells me if you work hard, what can happen.
The Spirits will keep it underneath as it goes out of bounds. 10:19 to go in the second quarter. And the Spirits won the first quarter, picking up a point in the standing.
Just talking about Fonville. Watching him before the game, he's got natural block shot. There it is. Shot blocking instinct. That's why I like this guy.
Good caller.
I'll tell you something. It is a big man's league. Duckworth, Manute Bol. If you're big and you work hard, good things can happen.
And Burt didn't bother that rejection a moment ago. He just came out, fired the jumper. He has six now, and it's 46-23, Savannah on top.
Listen, he can play. Steve Burt was at Iona. He stayed at Iona rather than leave because his grandmother was ill. She raised him when his parents died. He got 35 against Byron Scott, 32 against Glenn Rivers.
Anthony Frederick scores six. We'll tell you more about Steve Burt in a minute. He won a very special award for the New York area. This is Riley trying to get it inside.
Well, they better get it down on Lester because he is a big man.
Walker Russell swinging it for Steve Burt. Frederick comes up with it for Mississippi. The Jets in blue once again, and the Spirits in the light gray. 46-25 our score, 8-2 the quarter. Spirits lead both.
Both Bannister and Fonville playing at the same time. Bannister went to Europe. Looks like he's got more finesse this time. Watch him before the game with a little left-hander, some movement.
And a foul inside, loose ball foul.
Looks like they got Jackson on that one. Lewis really is the glue when he comes in for Mississippi. Right now, Mississippi's got to get something going. It's been all Savannah.
This is Walker Russell. Wilkins walks in a crowd, and that'll be a travel.
Got the foul. No. They got a charge.
Charging instead. And a technical foul has been called. On Tom Schneeman of the Mississippi Jets. They'll send Walker Russell to the line, and with good reason. He's an 82% free throw shooter.
That's unusual when the coach gets a T after he got the call, but Schneeman thought that there was a travel call, and it actually was a travel call. apparently he questioned Tommy Woods' birth and got one.
47-25, the Savannah Spirits lead the Mississippi Jets. We're in Savannah, Georgia, live on ESPN. Lewis Jackson for an easy one.
I like Jackson's game. A stone shooter. He's a quiet guy, but he is the glue. He gets them quietly. 9-4 ball game in this quarter.
Riley heavily down the middle, and out of bounds it goes. The Jets will get it back.
Talking about Lester Fonville, you saw he has no feet at all right now. No movement, and Riley, who isn't the quickest guy in the world, went by him like he's standing still. But who knows what's going to happen in a year? I hate to be redundant, Bob, but this Kevin Duckworth out of Eastern Illinois was a second-round pick of San Antonio, traded to Portland for Barry, and all he's doing now is going wild. He got 30 the other night against Denver.
Get the opportunity and make the most of it. And that's Anthony Frederick scoring. He's got 8. 47-29 now. The Jets are trying to sneak back into this one. A lot of time left. 8 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Russell, they swing it around to Burt in the corner. Burt's got it back. Off the heel. Fonville rebounding. Dropping it there for Ricky Wilson. He'll bring it across the timeline. 9-6 in the quarter. Savannah leading that department. Bannister. Tommy Woods said that was a long step and called him for the travel.
I tell you the difference. You know, Bannister's always had the reputation just being a pounder, a bruiser. That was a finesse move with the spin. Let's take a look. Watch him spin and make his move. And even though he traveled, and I'm not sure he did, that's what it's going to take if he's going to make it come expansion time.
There's a timeout on the floor. Spirits 47, the Jets 29. We'll be back in a minute. Welcome back to the Savannah Civic Center. We're live on ESPN for CBA basketball inside the huddle of Coach Henry Bibby of the Savannah Spirits. Henry's a great trivia question. The only guy to ever be a championship member of an NCAA, NBA, and CBA team. Only guy. You can use that one, Irv.
I refereed that ball game when they played Villanova. Remember Howard Porter was there? And Howard had signed early with an agent or something. They had to give him money back. Sidney Wicks was in that game. Steve Patterson, now to coach at Arizona State.
Folks, we'll have our CBA telephone poll coming up in just a minute. You can take part in today's telecast. We'll have a question for you. You can call in 60 cents and answer the question, what you think is the right response, as Walker Russell sends it up from outside. We'll give you the results, keep you updated throughout today's game. Glad you could be along with us.
That's the way you're supposed to play defense. Frederick watched the belt buckle, did not go for all the head and shoulder fakes of Walker Russell. Remember his brother Campy?
Yep. .707 remaining in the second quarter. Ophel Wilson is called for the foul. That's his second.
He comes out. Here's the all-time leading scorer, Tico Brown. And it's a different deal for Tico. He's 31 years of age. He ain't going anywhere. He played for Dwayne Morrison at Georgia Tech. And this guy has been around, and they love him down here.
Inside for Lewis Jackson, and he's hammered by Steve Burt.
Nice little pass on the baseline. Burt leads his team in block shots, even though he's about 6'1". This time he gets a piece of the arm.
Jackson for a pair. Third in the CBA in free throw shooting. 85% on the year.
Out of Alabama State. His coach was James Oliver in college, and he did a good job with him. This guy can post you up and shoot a jumper. He played with Kevin Lotter in college at Alabama State. Kevin played with Kansas City when the Kings were there, not in Sacramento.
Brown on the long fadeaway. Tico now with 8 points. 49-31, Savannah leading.
Talking to him before the game, I said, Tico, do you drive anymore? And he said, when the spirit moves me. Of course, these are the spirits now.
Bannister is inside. He is grabbed by Wilkins. And Ken Bannister, 6'9", will go to the line.
Trinidad Junior College. A guy named Jim Topol done a good job in that state. Went to Indiana State for Bill Hodges, then transferred. And he winds it up with St. Augustine.
Bannister now with 2 points, both coming from the line.
Much better second quarter, 11-9. He can cut it to a point.
Walker Russell comes down with the rebound. 49-32, Savannah leading. 6:30 to go here in the second period. Russell looking for Burke down the baseline. Pretty pass.
Solid pass indeed. You know what I like? A lot of guys have to make that transition. Their scores in college, just like Walker Russell was. Now he's got to be a point here. Nice by Frederick.
Frederick scoring. He has 10. Herb, the Savannah team doesn't look like the team that's lost five of their last six games. They're playing well.
Yeah, they really are ready to play. That's good defense by Bannister.
Almost a steal by Tico.
Well, that is how you stop the break, choke the guards.
And Burt comes up with a steal. It's a 3-on-2 for the Spirits. Burt had it stripped by Lewis Jackson.
Well, they're only 5-on-1. Let's see what happens.
Ricky Wilson. Got it.
Ricky's been an all-star. He's got that intensity. He ended up going to George Mason as we get the foul underneath. And the reason he went to George Mason, saying out of Maryland, he just liked the guy with the name of Rick Barnes. Let's take a look at the transition. Here they come, very hard. They spread the court. And there's the effort, and watch the defensive effort here and the foul.
Eddie Lee Wilkins at the line. He has 16 already here in the first half.
Tell you what kind of league it is, Bob. We watched Henry Bibby with Riley. They were showing Riley where to go before the game because there are a lot of trades made in this league. Enos Wadley just called up by Atlanta, 10-day deal. And that's why they're playing.
Wilkins leads the Spirits in both scoring and rebounding. 18 points now for the big man.
His mother's watching. He wanted to be sure and tell her hello.
All right, it's done. 53-36, the Spirits lead the Jets. Lewis Jackson backed it in nicely against Steve Burt.
What did you call that right? He pinned Burt down. That was a mismatch.
Jackson at 6'6", Burt only 6'2". 53-38, 5 minutes approaching here in the first half. Russell sends it from outside. Walker Russell with 5. This is Ricky Wilson. And Tommy Wood has the call.
Foul number 12, Steve Burton.
Ricky is actually better at penetrating than shooting, but he'll make the big shots for you.
The quarter stands at 17-15. Savannah leads that, and they lead the game 55-38. The CBA employs the same rules as the NBA with a few exceptions. We'll try to give those all to you, one of which is the no foul out rule. And Steve Burt picked up his third foul. You cannot foul out of a CBA game after your sixth foul. Any subsequent foul after that is administered as a technical, and the team gets a bonus free throw, but you can stay in the game.
It's Tom Schneider. Went to Dayton. He was there before Don Donner. So you know Tom's got a little gray tooth.
All right, let's talk about some of the news and the CBA to update you on. The player of the week, Jamie Waller from Charleston, averaged 25 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists, and 3 block shots. Bob Hill is the new coach of the Topeka Sizzlers. And the Albany Patroons, what a great start. 36-4, the best start in the CBA's history. 22 years. Attendance is up 26%. They think they might go over 1 million for the first time ever in the CBA. The folks outside and around this league are discovering that pro basketball outside the NBA can be exciting and interesting. And Wilkins is looking like an NBA prospect for sure. But they will wave that one off.
This big guy did a pretty good job. Watch Fonville. Watch Big Lester. Once again, he's got those shot-blocking tendencies. He'll go up. Bannister throws the elbow. And this thing is tied.
The quarter is tied at 17-all. 55-40 the score as the Spirits still in control of the game.
Foul number 20, Walker D. Russell. His second foul.
Greg Hines returns to the lineup for the Savannah Spirits, number 42.
Well, listen, this guy's got to be the main man here today. He proposed on his knees Saturday night on national TV to Jackie Davis. I mean, Valentine's Day.
Yep.
Huh?
Here's Lewis Jackson. Well, we're starting to see a lot more fouls called, but now it's slowed the tempo of the game down. They were really running it in that first quarter.
Well, maybe the officials knew the hockey game was on, and they were saving themselves to get some airtime.
1 out of 2 for Jackson. 55-41. This is Wilson. Ricky Wilson. Got it.
Was that a solid job? Picked him clean. The Jets with a 3-point lead in the quarter. They're down 12 for the game.
Steve Burt working on Ricky Wilson. They clear it out on the right side for him. Watch Riley cut through now. They have a two-man game going. Riley's turnaround off the high glass. No. Bannister rebound.
Bannister once got 24 rebounds. Charles Oakley, 25. As their two teams collided in the semifinals, the national championship, NAIA.
Inside, it's loose. Fonville. And Frederick inside. Steve Burt mixing it up with the big men. Now the Spirits take control. This is Russell. He waits for help. 3:20 to go in the third, or in the second quarter, rather. Hines sends it, no. Frederick spins away from Tico Brown. He goes by Burt and spins it in.
That's the best move of the day. I mean, he only had to beat three bodies.
12 points for Anthony Frederick.
And Jimmy Herrick, if you got a day off and you're watching, the guy you coach in college is looking pretty good.
And the Jets have come back to within 10 now. They were trailing by 21 at one point.
Burt. There's Lester.
Headed blocked by Fonville. It's loose and the Jets come away.
That's my man. I'm starting a fan club for Lester.
Wilson. Oh. And Fonville was not looking for the pass. Coming up at halftime, we'll have our CBA telephone poll. A question will be coming your way. You can take part of today's broadcast. 60-cent charge for the call, and we'll give you the results throughout. One of the issues in basketball today.
This guy's done a very good job once again.
A look at the scoring leaders as they stand today in the CBA. Tommy Davis on top from Pensacola. And you can see we've got Steve Burden, Ricky Wilson, and Eddie Wilkins, three of the top five in the league in today's game. Tico Brown, this one goes out of play. And I mentioned earlier that six of the league's top 13 scorers performing for us this afternoon here in Savannah. Glad you could be along with us. We have 2:20 to go in the second quarter.
Derek White comes in for Fonville. White, another guy who played for the Waves of Pepperdine.
And a whistle down low. And the Jets have taken the lead in the quarter, 22-17. And there you see it, Tico Brown for Savannah. Far and away, the all-time scorer in the league. He's played, this is in his eighth season in the CBA, was the 23rd player selected back in 1979 by the Utah Jazz.
So many great games, and I was talking to him a little bit about what's the best one. He says, I've scored more in other games. Probably the one he remembers best, he got 50 against Rochester. Did everything.
You know, Irvy scored 60 in a playoff game once,
yeah,
too, in, against Montana in the championship series. I guess the knock is defensively on him, although he thinks that he plays as good a defense as a lot of guys in the NBA.
2 minutes left in the quarter.
The Jets have made a nice comeback. They are trailing now just by 8, 55-47. They lead the quarter by 7.
Well, they do a good job. They get that basketball to the hash mark, and away they go. Nice block once again.
Jackson blocked the shot of Brown.
Here's a nice matchup. Watch the two Wilsons go at each other. Othell really can play defense. He was on a good basketball team with Sampson, Carlisle, Lamp.
That was a fine team. Eric White.
That should be Gray.
We have 1:27 remaining in the first half. Don't forget we have Halftime Magazine coming up for you. Special features, our CBA telephone poll. Irv will have a special guest and a whole lot more. Stay with us at halftime. Tico one-on-one against Lewis Jackson. The shot goes off for Hines, and he scores on the follow.
Oh, they step over the end line. Hines with a nice putback. as Henry Bibby looks on. Hines played with Ricky Mahorn at Hampton Institute. They once again went against Charles Oakley. That seems to be the barometer as we have a 20-second timeout. Everybody compares what they did against Oakley if they were in small college.
The quarter now is up for grabs, Irv. It appeared for a moment there that Mississippi had a 7-point lead. It's now just a 3-point lead in the quarter. Savannah still leads the game 59-47.
Here's where you really see some strategy, and Mississippi made a major mistake a moment ago when they stepped over the end line. The three-point rule, of course, is in effect, and the line is just a little closer than the NBA, a little further out than the collegiate game.
1:09 to go in the first half. A 12-point advantage for the hometown Savannah Spirits. The leading scorers. Wilkins with 16 to lead everybody.
All right, they step on the line. This should be three possessions now. Two for the guys in blue, Mississippi, and one for Savannah. And Tom Schneeman will use the clock here. Wants to win this quarter. Needs a hoop here, and that would probably cinch it up.
Eric White, offensive foul. A little too aggressive with the move.
This Humphrey's a young kid. He's a college student. He's a pretty good official. We've seen him a lot this year. Gets a little better every time, more confident. Here it is. Watch the move. Does a good job. Tico Brown with position.
There's some good defense for Tico Brown. He knows he can play it. Walker Russell sends it off the iron. Here comes a two-on-one for the Jets. Anthony Frederick, a good hustle by Phil Wilson as he came from all the way down the floor to break that play up.
Here's the situation. 36 left in the quarter, 20 on the game clock, a three-point lead. If you play defense here, you do have a chance to come down and tie. You need to stop right here.
And we're talking about that point that's up for grabs. You get a point for winning each quarter if you are new to the CBA. Every quarter, worth something big in the standings. 59-47 in the game. Savannah leads it. Forced up. Tico Brown had the rebound, and Frederick stripped it away. He goes to the hole. Big basket.
Indeed.
Fans wanted another offensive foul. They didn't get it.
Got to shoot a three-pointer and then foul somebody if you really want to win this quarter. There's Tico.
Tico Brown hits it. That's a two-pointer. Long shot from Frederick, no. Brown's got it. They got a chance to tie with 1 second. Russell did miss by much. An exciting conclusion to the first half. The Spirits lead 61-49. Mississippi won the quarter. They pick up a point. We'll be back with our halftime magazine and more professional basketball. This is the CBA on ESPN. Everybody, welcome back to the Savannah Civic Center. 61-49. The Spirits, playing at home, have the lead here. It's time now for our halftime magazine. I'm Bob Lewandowski. Coming up in just a few moments is the Minolta shot. Take your best shot. One fan, one shot for $1,000. That'll be coming up in just a few minutes. We'll update you. We'll give you that question for our CBA telephone poll. First of all, we have a perfect example of what it's like when you keep working hard. From the CBA to the NBA, you can realize the dream. Michael Adams is an example, and ESPN's Bob Lee has that story.
...of the NCAA tournament. Sacramento drafted him in the third round 3 years ago, and he spent 18 games with the Kings that year. About half of that season also in the CBA. the job was getting back to the National Basketball Association.
I think once I played in the CBA, I think the best thing for me to do was to, work hard to get out of there. I think it's a stepping stone for guys who want to make it back to the pros, and I think I just worked on my game an awful lot in order to get back here.
I knew Michael Adams was going to make it because when I recruited him, he had two choices of coming with me or going to another team, and he could have made more money at the other team. But I tried to convince him that if he came with us, we would prepare him for the NBA.
Adams made it back to the NBA in 1986 with a full season for the Washington Bullets. Then, he was part of a major trade, coming to the Denver Nuggets. His impact has been profound. Adams runs the club from the point guard slot. He's one of the league's leading three-point shooters, and his club is in the middle of the fight for the Midwest Division title. For Denver coach Doug Moe, it's another find from the ranks of the CBA. Adams joining fellow Nugget Mike Evans. Moe can use the help.
Mike Adams has been absolutely terrific for us. He gives us the up-tempo that we need in our style of play. So we've been fortunate in that we've gotten two little guys out of the CBA and Mike Evans has helped us through the years, and Mike Adams in a half a year has been a big help to us.
Has all this success surprised the 25-year-old guard?
I'm surprised that I'm a starter right now. I'm not surprised that I've been playing pretty good. I've never had any doubts about my ability at all. It's just that when you get to playing time, I think stats seem to come your way a little bit.
Adams' time in the CBA was well spent. It gave him an opportunity to improve, to be seen, and also to grow. And it's something he recommends.
A younger guy who first gets out of college and who doesn't make it his first go-round, if he wants to continue to play, I think the CBA is an opportunity for him to improve on his game and let NBA scouts watch him and see if they get another chance at it.
The CBA is the proving ground for the NBA. What a story on Michael Adams. My partner Irv Brown now is standing courtside with a very special guest. Irv, take it away.
Well, thank you, Bob. The mayor, John Rusaika. Hey, you got yourself a pretty good town. First time down. I ran down by the Savannah River. This is good living.
Good-looking city. Probably America's most beautiful city.
I like your enthusiasm. This helps having the spirits here. Tico Brown doesn't hurt a bit.
Tico Brown downtown with Tico, and the spirits are exciting. It's great to have the basketball here. We haven't had it for this our second year. With the spirits in town, and it's beautiful, it's exciting, great basketball.
I love your enthusiasm. Good luck, Your Honor.
Well, thank you, and it's great having ESPN back here.
Thank you, sir.
Come back again.
We will. All right. And talking about coming back, we'll be back right after this.
All right, coming up in just a minute, we'll have the Minolta Take Your Best Shot Contest. One fan, one shot for $1,000, courtesy of Minolta, the official camera of the CBA. And the Minolta Award goes to the best field goal percentage shooter of the CBA this year. And let's take a look right now how that's going. The current leaders in the CBA, Vince Hamilton of lacrosse. You can see at the top, Tony Campbell from Albany. Then there's Barry Mitchell, Ron Spivey going to Rockford, and Mark Davis. Those are the leaders in that field goal percentage award category. And the Freedom to Take Your Best Shot contest will be coming to an arena near you. All the CBA arenas will have their chance tonight at Pensacola, on the 19th at Albany, and February 24th, Rochester. Freedom to Take Your Best Shot. And each time, one fan will be randomly picked from the stands. They will shoot from 13 feet 9 inches. That is the distance of a free throw. They can shoot it at any angle, though. And the contest will be coming to all the CBA arenas this season. And now Irv is standing by with today's contestant.
All right, thank you, Bob. Bill Atkinson is a banker. He played a little junior high basketball, a little high school basketball. You look like you're ready to go, Bill. Can you do it for a grand?
No.
Well, there's a man with confidence. Go do your thing, Bill. His best shot for $1,000 from Manola. Bill Atkinson stepping up. I'm betting on him. I think he's conning us. I think he's a good shooter. Let's see what he does. Well, I'll guarantee he knew his stuff. He knew he wasn't going to do it. But you know what? We're going to take care of him. We got a dual camera from Minolta. Hey, Bobby, back to you.
All right. Thanks, Irvin. We'll have more basketball here. That concludes the CBA Halftime Magazine for February 15th. The score is Savannah 61, Mississippi 49. We'll be back with more of the CBA live on ESPN. Base. Mississippi Jets. Savannah battling for that fourth and final playoff spot in the East. Here are our leading scorers. Anthony Frederick, 14 for Mississippi. And Eddie Lee Wilkins has 16 for Savannah. He might have 18. I don't know. I'll check that.
Oh, he stole a tip. That didn't get called too often. Tommy Wood and Darrell Humphrey right on top of that. So it's Savannah's basketball.
And we wipe the slate clean. The quarter system, in effect, a seven-point system in the CBA. You win a quarter, you get a point in the standings. You win the game, you get four.
Nice little up-tempo game.
Good three, rather. I'm sorry. Eddie Lee Wilkins. And Eric White will send it up. And we start where we began in the first half. The team's going up and down the floor. Tico Brown in the corner. Spins over Seiler. We're just underway in the third quarter. Glad you'd be along with us.
Bannister is the starter, not Fonville, this half. We saw Lester early on.
If you just joined us, it's the Mississippi Jets in blue. That's Eric White inside.
That's a solid effort inside as they really hammer. Got a delay of the game. White did a nice job coming back and getting the stick back.
61-51, Savannah leading. See that red line on the floor is the three-point line. That is the CBA line. It stands at 22 feet. Inside is Wilkins, offense. And they're waving it off. Darrell Humphrey says, no, no, offensive foul.
I'll tell you something, this kid hangs in there pretty good. He's just a pup. Mentioned a college student. He gets a little better each time out. And any question about it, Wilkins through the left arm. And the supervisor of officials, that's five fouls. Supervisor of officials for the NBA, Daryl Gerritsen, has emphasized that call. They do a good job in pro ball.
Ophel Wilson the steal. And he runs the floor against White. And picks up the foul. Eric White. Third foul on Eric. All right, the CBA telephone poll. Do you think they should abolish the NBA college draft? If you think so, 1-900, that's the number. And if you think they should keep it, and we'll have the results.
Used to do that in baseball. We had some unusual salaries.
61-51, Savannah leading. So Seiler, and rejected by Hines. 3-on-1 spirit break, Russell. To Wilkins.
Boy, that was gift wrapped. Nice little bounce pass. If you're going to bounce it to somebody 6'10", you better make sure it's gift wrapped.
63-51. Savannah on top. The quarter even at 2-all. White. Inside for Bannister. He's grabbed.
Let's pick up the transition game once again. Now watch what a great job they do handle. Walker with the solid pass, and they finish up nicely with Eddie Lee Wilkins.
Wilkins moves pretty well for a big man, I'll tell you.
Yeah, he really does. Spent some time with the Knicks last year, and of course, what all these people are looking for is expansion. You see, we had the nice feature on Michael Adams. I see Michael Adams play a lot. He can flat play, and he's a little pup. They list him at 5'8". I think he's alive, about 5'7". But all these guys want a shot to get back up there. With expansion coming, it can happen. Enos Watley just got called up. Oh, he didn't get any iron that time.
Well, and they're giving it to Bannister here at the Savannah Civic Center. Pretty vocal crowd here on a Monday afternoon. Glad you could be along with us. 10:05 to go in the third. 63-51, Savannah leading.
These two teams played down in Mississippi and drew 11,000 people.
Wilkins' turnaround won't go. Here comes Kenny Seiler out of southern Mississippi.
But that guy can coach. That MK Turk gets no credit, and he can flat coach. He's got some players down there this year, too. They've been flirting in the top 10 most of the year.
Now they swing it on the wing for Anthony Frederick. He goes low for Ken Bannister. Pretty left-hand move.
It was awful easy. Eddie Wilkins very soft on that move.
Walker Russell working on Seiler. And they say Walker pushed off with the left arm.
Got him for hooking. I was talking about Mississippi. There's a guy right close down there at Gulfport, Mississippi, Chris Jackson. Everybody wants him. LSU was just in there. Got a legend for a coach, Burt Jenkins. Remember that name, Chris Jackson. He's only 6'1", does it all.
A 10-point Savannah lead, 63-53. Siler is watched by Tico Brown. Bannister, Hines with the block. Greg Hines, 6'7".
This is the most important thing, in my opinion, in pro basketball, is the block shot. You try and keep them in play like Kevin McHale does. In this case, you got to swat it out of bounds here, but Hines goes up. The leading shot blocker is only 6'1", Steve Burt.
Back to the action, Othell Wilson. Tried to feed it to Hines on the break. Tipped out of bounds, the Spirits will get it back. And a timeout called by the Savannah Spirits. They lead 63-53, 9 minutes to go in the third. You're watching the CBA on ESPN. NBA coaches now in the CBA, the latest addition, Bob Hill. Formerly with the Knicks, now the head man of the Topeka Sizzlers, Bill Musselman, you know about him. With the Albany Patroons, Musselman coach with the Cavaliers, Tom Nasalky's at Rapid City. And look where the Albany Patroons fit in the best starts in basketball history. An amazing 36-4 is where they stand today. And that's not too bad, Irv.
You know what's amazing about that? Because you do get some people who try and do it individually in this league so they can get back up in the NBA. Albany does it with teamwork, and there's no more unselfish player in the world than Sidney Lowe.
He's been with Bill Musselman wherever he's gone in the CBA. He was with a Thriller team in Tampa, Rapid City. Bill Musselman's teams have won 3 consecutive CBA championships, and boy, they're favored for a 4th.
Eric White got the foul. We're talking about CBA coaches. It makes some sense. Bob Hill going to Topeka. He was an assistant coach at Kansas under Ted Owen. Larry Brown knows the area.
Eddie Lee Wilkins thought he'd better pass it off to Tico, but they call 3 seconds on him.
They normally give you 4 when in there, but when you pass the ball and you're in the keyhole, you better get out of there. And he didn't do it. Eddie stayed.
Still a 10-point lead for Savannah. 8:35 to go in the third. Mississippi leads the quarter 4-2. Here's Siler over Hines.
That's a nice effort by Kenny. He played 20 minutes in the first half, scored 4 points. Is a hometown guy.
Siler with 6 now, and it's a 63-55 tally. Brown in trouble, finds Wilkins underneath.
It's a nice effort by Tico.
Ricky Wilson brings it back. Bad pass. He was looking inside for Eric White, and the Spirits will get it back.
I think it's settled down. It is a 10-point game, but the most important thing are the quarters. We're even at 1 apiece. And right now, the guests lead at 6-4. That's Mississippi taking on Savannah.
You get 3 if you win the game. 3 points in the standings. 1 point for winning a quarter. Wilson in trouble. Dished it back out for Hines. He got it to go. 13 for Greg Hines. 67-55. The Savannah Spirits in control by a dozen. The quarter is all even at 6 now.
Want to go inside.
White. Got it.
He's got some ability. Didn't play much in the first half. And Eric White averages 20 a game.
Spirits by 10. They've got the basketball. Hines for Russell. Good bounce into Wilkins. And a whistle in the lane.
Walker Russell runs the show. Here's a solid pass. There's the flash. Puts it on the ground. There's the foul. They wanted the charge. Don't get it. Call goes against him. Hits him on the arm. Eddie Lee going to the line.
Our Eastern Division standings. There you see the Albany Patroons running away with it, but Mississippi solidly in second, and you can see Savannah in today's game trying to win and stay in fourth place.
That's Lewis Jackson back in.
Unofficially, I have Wilkins for 24 points. And it's 69-57, Savannah leading. Quarter is all tied. 7 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Ricky Hines Wilson.
And, excuse me, Bob. Hines and Bannister killing each other.
Ricky Wilson missed it inside. Othell Wilson for the Spirits. Tipped it out of bounds. Mississippi will get it back.
He wants that 29 against Clemson. His mother, Estelle, is watching today. Well, listen, mothers are supposed to watch. That's part of it, isn't it?
Yeah, they better. And that'll count. Strong move inside by Ken Bannister. And Tico Brown gets the foul call.
He honestly has changed his game. Always could rebound. Mentioned he got 24. Oakley, who went to Charles Oakley, that is, got 25 when those two schools played each other. But he's worked on some moves. I was watching before the game, a little left-handed move that I've never seen him use.
They just nicked the iron.
Well, he's getting better because he didn't get any of it last time.
He missed it the last time. 69-59. Savannah still on top. Walker Russell, long range. Rattled it in.
PA guy like that. Walker Russell played for Les Wickie. Here comes Othell.
Russell! Would have counted if it went. Lewis Jackson called for the foul in the lane.
There's Henry Bibby. He could flat play. I like the way he took care of the basketball. Right, look at that. Henry coaching here. Of course, Kazzy at Wyoming. Kazzy's good for the league. I like that big smile.
Walker Russell hits it. Phil Jackson was coaching last year, and now an assistant in the NBA, was a player for us.
He's at Chicago with Tex Winters, John Bach. You talk about having some experience on that bench. Doug Collins has it. And I'll tell you something, Doug Collins, a lot of people forget Doug Collins as Tico comes back in. Doug Collins was with Henry Bibby down at Arizona State. They were both assistants when Bobby Weinhauer had that job, so he's worked with him.
12-10 in the quarter, Savannah leading. They lead the game 73-59, 6-10 to go in the third.
I really believe if Walker Russell would get that weight down about 2.5, he's about 2.15 now, he was 2.27, he eats junk food.
Frederick got it to roll. Anthony Frederick now with 16. Better do something with it.
That's a pretty good trap.
Yeah. Shuffle the feet as Walker Russell was tightroping the far sideline. Savannah calls timeout. We have 5:48 to go in the third. We'll take a timeout our own. And it's 73-61. The Spirits lead the Jets. You're watching the CBA on ESPN. We are back at the Savannah Civic Center, along with Irv Brown, Bob Lewandowski. We've got a nice crowd on hand here, and they're making some noise here, Irv, to try to get the Savannah Spirits over the top.
They certainly are. Got a nice little crowd here. President's Day.
These two teams played before the largest crowd ever in the CBA. That was at Mississippi, 11,153. Saw that one in Savannah. Beat Mississippi at home, and we are just about to 1 million is the estimated projection for the growing attendance of the CBA. Well, pro basketball, and it's good.
I think that they've added a lot of towns where there's interest. Plus, one of the big reasons, in my opinion, they've been able to keep some bigger people from going to Europe.
That'll count as Fredericks fires it from outside. Anthony Frederick.
Let's pick it up. Anthony Frederick has had a big ball game. Goes up. Gets hit on the arm. Anthony's got a chance. Southern California kid came down to Clemson and Pepperdine. He stayed at home.
Frederick for 19 points now. 73-64, Savannah leading. But Mississippi has gone ahead in the quarter, 15-12.
Both men lean on each other. We got a whistle underneath.
Friday, you can see ESPN action, Rockford at Charleston, 4 o'clock Eastern time. Bob Lee will be back for that one. That's Friday at 4 o'clock, Rockford, at the Charleston Gunners.
Elson Turner saw some time with the Denver Nuggets playing there. One guy we won't see is Pete Myers. Pete is with San Antonio, and we've had him on several telecasts. He's done an outstanding job. That first game at Rapid City, I just thought the guy was terrific. Next to last player in the draft just shows you what you can do if you work hard. He was out of Arkansas, Little Rock. Nobody gave him a chance, and now he's playing in the NBA.
Spirits lead by 11. This is Frederick in a crowd. Bannister's tip. Hines chased it, and the Spirits will get it back.
That was a nasty trap. I mean, they were everywhere. Normally, they don't move as a unit when people trap. They stayed with it pretty good.
Good save by Walker Russell. He's open in the corner. In and out. Lewis Jackson rebounding. This is Ricky Wilson. Ricky, good pass inside for Bannister.
Threads the needle. Ricky Wilson, that's what a point guard is supposed to. He's a scorer in college.
75-66 our score, 17-14 in the quarter. Mississippi leads the quarter but trails the game. Tico Brown and a beautiful steal by Frederick. It's a two-on-one.
Boy, all of a sudden, they jumped this thing up five.
75-68. Savannah leading, but Mississippi threatening now. They're making a run here in the third quarter with 4:20 to go. That's Brown. Tico hits it. 12 points for Tico Brown.
I wonder if Tico rips himself. He's the sports director here of a radio station, WZAT. I wonder if he has a bad day if he says, oh, Tico Brown stunk. This is Tico Brown reporting for WZAT.
Lewis Jackson going to Bannister. Muscles it up off the glass. Hines has the rebound. Othell Wilson. That's goaltending. They'll count it. And the foul.
That's interesting. There's the effort, and there's the slam off the glass, and there ain't any question about it. Lewis Jackson goes up, and anytime you drill it off the glass, that's goaltending. All of a sudden, we're going to be tied if he makes this. You know, this is like shooting outside. Remember when guys used to shoot outside and they didn't plan on the wind?
Yeah. Henry Bibby wondering what the Savannah Spirits are doing. They have to try to get the momentum back on their side of things. They still lead the game, 79-68. They've been able to hold off Mississippi so far. The Jets lead the quarter by one. Each team has won a quarter, picking up a point in the standings. Lewis Jackson had rejected inside by Burt, who is back into the game. Tico Brown comes down with it. And the foul is called. Anthony Frederick.
Tico did a good job boarding that time. Tom Schneeman. Boy, has he been everywhere. And I like his manner with the kids, and they respect him. They use young kids, too.
Tico Brown, a fine free throw shooter at 81%. Boy, there are some great scorers, great players in this league. Brown, of course, one of them. 14 points for Tico now, 81-68.
I think what happens, a lot of people think that this is a Humpty Dumpty league until they come in and actually compete against them. I'll give you a good example. Michael Ray Richardson, several times an All-Star, saw him when Albany played Rockford. Let me tell you what, there were some guards out there that were right with him. Pete Myers, I mean, there's some people that can play in this league. Most are missing one thing, that's why they're not up there. Usually it's right place, right time. And once again, going back to the example of a Ricky Green or Michael Adams or Brad Davis, they got with ball clubs that could utilize their talent.
Ricky Wilson now looking for his 14th point, will not get it. Othell Wilson, the long rebound. Now the fans across the country are coming to realize there are fine professional players outside the NBA, and they're right here in the CBA. 81-69, Savannah leading. 3:05 to go in the third. Wilson down the middle.
Solid job by Ricky.
He's fourth in the league in scoring now with 15 points.
He never smiles. Love his intensity.
Othell Wilson against Ricky Wilson. Out of the corner is Burt for the long range bomb. That's over the backboard and out of bounds. Look at this. It's easier to get struck and killed by lightning or earth than it is to become a professional basketball player.
Yeah, well, I'll pass.
I don't know. We will take a short timeout. 81-71, Savannah leading. This is the CBA on ESPN.
We're back, and there's Chet Simmons. Used to be the ESPN president. What a job he did up there. Former USFL commissioner, was at NBC, and he lives down here in Savannah. Got a kid that's getting ready to go to college up in Colorado, and Chet's taking care of him. Looks good.
All right, our telephone poll for February 15th. Do you believe the college draft, the NBA college draft, should be abolished? 1-900-260-2221, if you think they should. If you want to keep it the same way, 1-900-260-2222. Call now, 60 cents is the charge for the call, and we'll have the results a little bit later on for you. Hope you're enjoying today's contest live from the Savannah Civic Center. I'm Bob Lewandowski, along with Irv Brown. 81-71, the Savannah Spirits lead the Mississippi Jets. 2:35 left in the third. Seiler, great fake, and around Bert he goes. Hines has the rebound. On the release to Bert. Good feed to Riley.
Riley had a choice to make to go to Kansas and play for Larry Brown or go to Tulsa. Pick Tulsa's from Muskogee.
Frederick took it in too deep. Here's Burt.
Nice.
Dropping it for Riley again.
Solid little run and a two-point lead with 2:07 left.
Good timeout, and the Spirits come out flying. 85-71. They lead the quarter now, 24-22. We are just under 2 minutes to play here in the third. Wilson, long range, that's 3 points.
That'll break your will. They tried to double down and keep it out of the middle, away from Bannister, and they get burned.
Ricky Wilson buries it from way outside, 85-74. Tico Brown against Lewis Jackson. On top for Othell Wilson, watched by Ricky Wilson. Othell looking for a pick. Dumping it into Riley.
Well, he's the shot clock expired. Bob, he's taking over. He has the last 6 points for the Spirits.
Riley coming alive offensively, and an offensive foul called on Ricky Wilson.
Riley's done it all. He scored 6 points. He draws a charge. 1:15 left. His ball club is in command by a point this period.
They just got Mr. Brian Riley from Topeka Sizzlers. He's averaged 10 points on the season with them. He's a rookie out of Tulsa.
Look at this set. Clear aside. Nice.
Wilson down the middle.
That's a great effort. Everybody was looking for Burt to penetrate. Instead, Wilson goes down the middle. That's called by Henry Bibby.
And all of a sudden, the Spirits lead by 15.
Remember when Henry Bibby coached Nancy Lieberman in the U.S. Basketball League?
And the Spirits lead the quarter by 3, 28-25. They lead the game by 15 with 40 seconds to go in the third.
Use some clock if they get a hoop here.
And they took
10 seconds.
They used a little too much clock.
Well, I tell you, Tommy Wood was definite with that call. Nobody said a word to him.
Well,
you don't see that
too often. What a mistake. No, you don't.
Should go for three here. They're down three. This is the last possession they'll get unless there's a foul, so they should go for three to tie it.
Jackson will try three.
See if they kick it back out.
Frederick off the glass.
Now they got to get that clock. Well, I'll tell you what, they get it back with 3 seconds left, so they don't need to foul. They just need a stop. Use a 20-second timeout if they choose.
Savannah leads the quarter by one. 16 seconds now to go in the third quarter.
That's what I like about the league. It's crunch time, and it's in the third quarter.
Wilson finds Tico Brown. Five on the shot clock. Tico, 3 points.
Well, that decided that.
And that should lock up the quarter for Savannah.
Should be a four-point lead. They finally get the clock squared away.
Bannister goes strong to the hole, but the Spirits will win the quarter. They pick up a point in the Eastern Division standings. It's Savannah 92, Mississippi 78. Back with more of the CBA on ESPN. Back to the Savannah Civic Center. Boy, they're having a party here. I'm Bob Lewandowski along with Irv Brown. And if you want an official basketball of the CBA, it's a Wilson. Mail $53 to CBA Official Ball, 425 South Cherry Street, Denver, Colorado, 80222. It's a nice rock there. Enthusiastic gathering at the Savannah Civic Center, and they will wipe the slate clean as we go to quarter number four. 92-78 Savannah leading. Irv, the Spirits badly needed a victory here. Losers of five of their last six. They made the player transactions in the last day or so. And boy, they're coming out fired up today.
Well, they've done a good job. Wilkins with 20, Brown with 17. What's interesting, Riley just joined the club. They were walking him around the court, showing him where to stand and everything. He is the reason I think they won the quarter. Six straight points, drew the charge, and he starts here in the fourth. And that's what you have to understand about the CBA. There are going to be changes. That transaction wire, it's there every single day.
Irv, I've been associated with the league for a few years, and changes is something I'm getting used to.
Well, an example, Chip England was picked up in a trade. I'm not sure if Chip's going to report or not. This guy's as good a shooter as there is. He comes off a pick, and he flat buries a shot. He's supposed to come down and play for Savannah.
Steve Burt nearly lost it. Hines forces one up. The Jets on the run. Eric White missed it inside. Tico Brown with the rebound. Here's Othell Wilson.
See what kind of decision he makes on the run. Good decision. Nothing there. Play for a solid gentleman in Terry Holland. It's good to play for. He does a good job with his kids, and he's had big wins over the years.
Tip. This man. Riley had the tip, and it went halfway down and came back out.
You're talking about Holland. He has knocked off some folks he's not supposed to beat. Here's the action under the board. There's the drive the hole. Beats him to the turn. Goes up. Doesn't happen. Riley, who's been terrific, misses the tap, but just won't stay down, and they get it back out of bounds.
Steve Burt, no. Bannister battling Hines for the rebound, and they'll give it back to the Spirits.
Outside shooting just hasn't been there second half.
Coming up next Friday at 4 o'clock, the ESPN CBA contest will be Rockford at Charleston. Coming up this Friday on ESPN, 4 o'clock Eastern. And Riley takes it inside. He'll get credit for the basket on the goaltending call.
All right, let's take a look. Riley goes up strong. Watch Jackson. He goes up and gets his hand on it in the glass. Fonville is back in.
94-78. We are in the fourth quarter. Savannah leading Mississippi. Good feed for Lewis Jackson. He is fouled by Hines. Greg Hines questioning Daryl Humphreys' decision on that foul call.
Well, they're going to do that because he just looks too young. He's a kid.
And Lewis Jackson at the line. Picked by Golden State on the third round in 1984. I've got him for 10 points in the game. He's third in the league in free throw percentage at 85%. Almost automatic with him. '84-'80. Here come the Spirits with the ball. They lead by 14. A quarter, even at two. And Riley.
That was
6-10, Brian Riley.
That was over 7-2, Lester Fonville.
A big man taking it outside. Well, what a great job that Brian Riley is doing. We can't say enough about it, Irv. They just said they're walking him through the offense this morning. He just came into town, and he's really contributing. Tico Brown buries one.
Tell you what, I think that a mayor down here, John Reflectus, who we interviewed at halftime, better hope that Tico doesn't run for mayor. He might win. Pretty popular guy, but you're right about Riley.
What a contribution.
Well, he's always been a good shooter, Bob.
98-80, the score, 10 minutes remaining in the fourth. Brian Riley with 14 points.
When you talk about shooters, I've seen three in this league that can shoot with anybody. D-Nut, Dennis Nutt, Chip England, and Dale Blaney.
Bannister, a left-hander, no. Long release to Tico Brown.
He really has been around a long time. He knows how to score in this league, knows when to go to the hole, knows when to use his opportunities.
And that outlet pass was by Brian Riley. He found Tico Brown on the fly pattern, spun one in, a 20-point lead for Savannah. The quarter score 8-2. As you can see, the Savannah Spirits lead that department, but they have rolled up a 20-point lead now, where Mississippi had come back to close to within 7. 9:34 to go here in the fourth quarter, and we'll be back in just a moment. It's Savannah 100, Mississippi 80. This is the CBA on ESPN.
I like that.
And that'll be announced live during the playoffs, and you'll see those right here on ESPN. Don't forget about Big Monday coming up later on with Bob Lee. He'll be there at 7:30. Villanova and Georgetown, followed by Purdue and Iowa. If you like your college basketball, a double dip dandy coming up later. Fonville's shot is short. Greg Hines comes down with it. Here's Steve Burton. Got through a pick and the foul.
Once again, Lester having a tough time moving those feet. Guy blows by him. Take a look. Once again, I just think this guy will work all summer, and then you'll see. But he just doesn't have good feet. Feel like you take a 25-year-old and put him in an automobile and tell him to drive, and he's never driven before. And that's exactly what's going on with Lester. He's just raw, period. But if the spirit is willing, you hate to be redundant, but I saw this Duckworth, I couldn't believe it. Lost 50 pounds, developed a few moves, and he's going to be around the NBA a long time. He got a chance because Steve Johnson got hurt up in Portland.
10 points now for Steve Burt. It's 102-80. This is where that CBA 7-point system comes in. The quarter's still up for grabs. Lewis Jackson, as the shot clock was about to run down, and Bannister has to follow for the easy one. 16 for Ken Bannister. Mississippi in second place in the East, Savannah in fourth, trying to stay there. Riley, no. Ricky Wilson. Kenny Seiler.
You notice how they spell Seiler's name on the back of his shirt? It's S-I-E.
Siles.
They ran out of R's. Three-pointer for Siles. Siles Seiler.
9 points for Kenny. Either way you cut it. 102-85 our score. 10-7 in the quarter. Savannah leads both. 10 on the shot clock. Brown hands to Wilson.
5 seconds.
Othell launches. Bannister rebounds for Ricky Wilson. Kenny Seiler. And the foul on Brian Riley.
Seiler's starting to take charge now. He's got a chance to cut this lead to a point and a quarter. Southern Mississippi's got a good program. They get very little credit. Everybody talks about their football players. Few talk about what kind of a job this MK Turk has done. You better be ready to play, you go down there.
Seiler, 1 out of 2. Now he has 10 in the game. He's a rookie in the CBA. Now the Wilsons battling Othell against Ricky. Othell looking for Brian Riley on the wing to Tico Brown. Tico, the running jumper, no. Fonville comes up with a loose ball. Seiler will launch it. Wilson for the Spirits. Hurt flies it to the hole, looking for Hines.
Well, there had to be something under there.
Finally, we get a whistle inside. They call 7-2 Lester Fonville. Here it is.
Here it is, and the action gets pretty tough under here. Watch this. And well, just got a little foul. Deion Welton out of St. Thomas, Florida, comes in. First time we've seen him. Personable guy, outside shooter, and that's, I'm sure, what Tom Schneeman is looking for here. It's tough. He hadn't worked up a sweat. He's ice cold. He's in here for the 7 minutes left in the ballgame and a quarter, very much in doubt.
Hines gets a pair, 104-86. Approaching 7 minutes to go, 12-8 the quarter score. Savannah on top. And Wilson draws contact. Ricky Wilson fouled by Othell Wilson.
Ricky looks for those gaps and he found that. And he gets fouled. 12-8, his ball club trails the period with 6:57 left.
Two for Ricky Wilson. I've got him for 20. 104-88 their score. Now Mississippi has pulled within two, though, in the quarter score. Burt shaking and baking to the hole. Hines.
He walked. Now they got him first for a foul. Tommy Woods outside.
And Lester Fonville.
Let's take a look. He traveled after the foul. That's one of the reasons he traveled. There's the contact inside. Ball is on the ground. They'll take it out.
Brown inbounds for Wilson. He's watched there by Deion Welton. And Deion will get into the scorebook first with the foul. 6-1 out of St. Thomas. Played some ball in West Germany overseas.
Only guy we haven't seen from Mississippi is Scott Thompson, that 7-foot center from San Diego.
Hines over Bannister. Air ball. Here's Ricky Wilson.
Boy, that's how you get hurt.
And they'll call Othell Wilson with the block.
No regard for the body. Ricky Wilson really, really goes hard to the hole. Watch this. Up in the air, when you're airborne like that, David Thompson, they thought he had a serious injury when he landed on his head in that regional year that the North Carolina State won the national championship.
Mm-hmm. As you said, when you're airborne like that, it doesn't take much to send you to the deck.
And there is a gentleman's agreement among the pros that you don't dump him. You notice Othell didn't dump him. The guy who's airborne causes it. He's just so out of control.
Wilson splits a pair.
I guess one of the amazing things is a guy like Julius Erving didn't get hurt as much as he was up in the air and extending and off balance.
That's like Jordan and Wilkins, too.
Good point.
12-11 the quarter score. Fourth quarter still very much up for grabs. 104-89 in the game. Savannah leading Mississippi. Tico hangs it up off the rim. We've got a foul.
Get every move of the book, Denny.
Lewis Jackson called for the contact.
Tico still has his quickness. He's 31, but that first step is still there. Knows how to score, runs the court well.
Here comes Walker D. Russell back into the game to replace Othell Wilson for the Savannah Spirits, as Tico will try to make it 2-for-2 this trip.
He's with Indiana. Year ago, got 16 in Boston against the Celtics.
106-89, 14-11 though in the quarter. Savannah leading by three in the quarter. Deion Welton. Wilson, no. If you think they should abolish the NBA college draft, call 1-900-260-2221. If you think they should just keep it the same, 1-900-260-2222. Last chance to vote, 60 cents it'll cost you for the call. We'll give you the results coming up in just a little bit. 106-89, Savannah leads Mississippi. We'll be back with more of the CBA on ESPN. One-sided Mississippi will still try to get a point in the standings, and that's what it's all about, and that's what the fans love. They love that. 42 players from the CBA are now in the NBA. Look at the referees and one head coach. And it's only going to grow as this league continues to expand.
Well, one of the better things they do is train the referees down here. In fact, I noticed, I looked at the box score the other night, Savannah was playing Ronnie Gerritsen. Works the NBA is working the game, so when you're getting your training, we got a travel call. Makes some sense to have somebody work the same brand of ball that they're going to be working rather than work college or high school.
106-89, stay tuned. We'll have the phone poll results here in just a few moments. 5:30 to go in this one. 106-89, the Spirits with a big lead over the Jets.
Well, look at this mismatch. That's like stealing it.
Russell inside. 11 points.
Nice call by Henry Bibby.
Deion Welton tries for three. And Eddie Wilkins battling there for the rebound. He and Bannister tie it up. Seiler back in, and Ricky Wilson sits down for Mississippi. Jets control the tap. Lewis Jackson inbounding for Seiler. Bannister over Wilkins and Lester Fonville.
That is first two of the game.
A putback jam for Lester, 108-91.
Lester's no offensive threat, but when you can block shots like that, I know what Schneeman will do. He'll have him throwing that thing up 1,000 times this summer, posting up. Here they come on a break with Welton.
Two on two, Seiler for Lewis Jackson.
Makes a lot of difference when Ricky Wilson would have the ball. Wilson would have taken it to the hole in transition to throw it away.
Spirits come back. Burt feeding Wilkins. He wanted the foul, didn't get it. Lewis Jackson's got a three on two. They need some points in a hurry, and Lewis will fill it up from three.
All of a sudden, it's tied. Lewis knew what he was doing.
The quarter is tied at 16. But 108-94, Spirits lead the game. And a timeout for the Spirits. 4:07 to go. Now here comes that CBA strategy. We'll tell you more about it in just a moment. We'll take a break. 4:07 left. 108-94. The Spirits lead the Jets. We'll be back in a moment.
Yeah, just what I suspected. Got a bad power pump on 18.
All right, Dave.
So don't worry. We'll get you fixed up.
This is from the CBA in the NBA. Some great names there, Herb.
Well, yeah, once again, right place, right time. Detroit's right up there battling. They got Lewis now. This is what I like. Winston Garland, I saw him just dominate a game, and he was down here playing in the CBA.
Clinton Wheeler, a veteran CBA player, really worked hard here.
He's a high school wrestler.
Wes Matthews. Good group of athletes, and that's what it's all about in pro hoops.
Nice names there.
We are live at the Savannah Civic Center. 4 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. The quarter score is tied at 16, and the Jets come up with a steal.
Guess who? Ricky Wilson.
Wilson back after a short break, beats Kenny Seiler.
He's been pulling everything to the left. Every shot he's thrown up has been wide left.
Here comes Walker Russell back for the Savannah Spirits. Tico, short on the three-pointer.
Always happens on that long rebound. Tom Schneeman just throws his hands up in disgust, but anytime you pop that three-pointer, if it misses, it's coming out long.
And Steve Bird, who's got the ball, had the easiest rebound he'll ever get. Russell inside.
That's a nice pass.
I was just going to say a beautiful feed from Steve Bird.
Plus, it helps when you have a sharp flash like that. If you go lackadaisical and don't make a good cut, you don't get rewarded. That's what separates Bobby Knight. A lot of people want to know why he's so much better than most coaches. The sharper cuts. That's what they do.
Steve Bird, who just made that beautiful pass, is called for the foul. Ricky Wilson will go. And forget this coming Friday on ESPN, Rockford Lightning against the Charleston Gunners. 4 o'clock Eastern Time live here on ESPN. And another reminder coming up just a little bit later on, Big Monday. The Big East and the Big Ten featured Villanova, Georgetown, Purdue, and Iowa. Bob Lee will be along at 7:30 on ESPN for that one.
I'll tell you something, he does as good a job in the studio as he does play-by-play. The guy's very talented. We got a foul.
Ricky Wilson with 23 points unofficially, 2:55 to go in the fourth. It's 110-96. But with those two free throws, the quarter is even at 18. Again, now Mississippi trailing big here, but they can still pick up a point in the standings by winning this quarter.
Burt without a basketball for a couple years, didn't know what he wanted to do with his life. He was in graduate school, decided to give it another fling. Had a big year, and he does it off the bench. I like the way Bibby uses him.
Didn't have the kind of scoring day that he's used to this season, but still a good contribution from Steve Burt. Savannah leads the quarter and the game. We get the block call.
That's tough. I can't blame Henry Bibby for being mad, nor Tico Brown. Tico's seen a few fouls. His old coach, Dwayne Harrison, used to wear a crew cut down in Atlanta. He used to wear them funny-looking suits. I used to like going there and see him. He's all right.
Lewis Jackson out of Alabama State. Another veteran CBA player of Toronto, Pensacola, now Mississippi.
See if they beat the pressure.
Burt holds it back outside. Now Russell. Jets trying to pressure the ball wherever it goes. 10 seconds
working
on the shot clock. Nice feed into Riley. He missed it. Wilkins is hammered. He'll go to the line.
Big play. Right place, right time. Eddie Lee Wilkins drips in. He really needed to get a stick back or keep the possession. He'll go to the line. Look at this. Riley with a hard drive to the goal. They protected pretty good, but there's Eddie Lee Wilkins. Nobody blocks out. He's got a chance to break this tie. He's a little short. Let's see if he adjusts. Yep,
perfect. Wilkins, 26 points I have him for. 113-97. A 16-point lead for the Spirits, but the intensity still on the floor because of the quarter-point system. 21-19 in the quarter, and the whistle.
That should be on Riley. Anthony Frederick is quicker than Riley. Took that first step. Brian with the blocking call.
Spirits have won two quarters. Mississippi has won the other. The winner of the game gets 3 points in the standings.
I thought Frederick was terrific in the second quarter. Mississippi won that particular period.
Savannah leads the quarter 21-20. They lead the game
113-98. Well, I tell you, they run three at you when they want to trap.
Burt. What a pass.
That's the problem with the trap. Somebody gets open when you gamble.
Wilson goes all the way to the hole.
How come nobody stuck him in the cheap seats? That's what bothers the coach. Henry Bibby going well. Nobody nailed him.
Burt spins away from Wilson.
Monster jam by Eddie Lee. And Riley is laughing.
Mississippi calls time with 1:42 to go. The Spirits lead 117 to 100. We'll be back with more. This is the CBA on ESPN. They are rocking it here at the Savannah Civic Center. The Spirits have all but wrapped up the game, but the quarter's still up for grabs. Glad you could be with us. Here's tonight's games on the CBA schedule. Topeka at Pensacola. Rapid City will take on Rochester. Quad City visiting Rockford, Illinois. All those starting times Eastern time. Albany at Charleston. Rapid City at La Crosse, and correction on it, local times. Those are the games in the CBA's schedule for tonight and tomorrow.
See what Tom Schneeman chooses to do here now. You go quick to the hole and not use any clock. You think about three-pointers, and that's what he's doing. And yes.
Yes, and Lewis Jackson connecting.
What is that changing?
And the quarter now tied at 25. The game within the game here in the CBA.
This is the second time Jackson has tied it in this period with a three-pointer.
You would never know that the Spirits had a 14-point lead in this game the way the teams are going at it, the intensity. Here's Burt down the middle. Missed the left-hand layup. Frederick rebounding in outlets for Wilson. Goes right around Russell. Walker D with the Matador defense.
Their trap paid off. 109 left. Let's see what they do with this end now. Got and that basketball because of the trap.
Now Mississippi has taken the lead in the quarter, and the foul on the baseline. Lewis Jackson got a piece of Brian Riley.
Here's a situation with 59 seconds left. You're looking at three possessions. Send Riley to the line. Two-point game. Bannister will come back in. See, that's when I kind of get fired up. I like to see what the coaches do this time of the game. Day of the game. A lot of people coach during the week. It's a day of the game that counts. The decisions that you make right now. Here's where you earn your money. Can't do a thing about talent. That's up to the front office. They can wheel and deal.
And they love to wheel and deal in the CBA. Brian Riley just came to the team this morning. Flew into town. Picked up from Topeka. 17 points for the 6'10 rookie from Tulsa. 27-26, Mississippi with the ball and the quarter lead. They lead the quarter. They trail the game, though, 118-105. Wilson.
Oh, that's blue ball with 47 seconds left.
Mississippi gets it back.
I take it inside. Make them make a decision. Illegal defense, that's a warning.
And our phone poll results. And people think, let's leave the NBA college draft the way it is. Players Association would like to see a total free agent system. You folks at home think things are going well just the way they are. Wilson down the middle, and that'll count plus the foul.
It has been Wilson and Jackson in this fourth quarter. Now, if you get this point down, you got the big even number. That's what you want with a three-point game. Tico Brown is in.
I already told you early on, these two teams love to put the ball up, and two of the highest scoring teams in the league at 118.
The Spirits got that today. Four-point game.
And a timeout called by Savannah with 37 seconds to go. They lead the game by 10, but trail the quarter by 4. And we will keep it right here for you.
Well, obviously, tell you what Henry Bibby's going to do. He wants to get it on the glass as quick as he can and then get the clock stopped. If you can get it on the glass, there's 37 seconds left. You get a shot down and then get a stop, you're still in this thing. If you don't get it down before the 24-second time, and that's all that's left, then you got a foul. It's as simple as that.
The Spirits lead by 10. They will win the game. But as you can see, the quarter still very much in question.
This guy's done a good job. They had a lot of disarray in Mississippi, got a late start. Schneeman has put it together with patience. Hanging around the lobby today, those guys don't know me from Adam. They talk about their coach, they talk about it with respect. There's Henry Bibby. See what he has to say, see what we hear.
All right. Spirits will inbound midcourt. 37 seconds left. They trail the quarter by four.
See how quick they get it to the hole. There he goes.
Tico. Well, looking for Hines, and the Jets come up with it. And that'll finish it. Frederick with the stuff.
Okay, what won a ball game, or the quarter for him, is their defense. They got a few traps, and it paid off big.
Hurt goes all the way.
Nice block by Lester Fonville.
Ten seconds. Wilson, yes.
So the Spirits are going to win the basketball game, and Mississippi is going to get 2 points.
Final score 118 to 112. Savannah wins the game. Mississippi wins the quarter. We'll be back to wrap things up in just a moment.